Well, there's no doubt that plenty of grills are being fired up this Memorial Day, and today some common grilling mistakes that could be messing with both your taste buds and your health. Got to talk about this, Chef Gerard Viverito. Am I saying that right?
You got it.
Okay. Director of Culinary Education for Passion Fish, that is an NGO nonprofit organization, is here to fill us in. Good to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
And we're talking mistakes not only on the grill, but it sounds like some mistakes that people are making even when it comes to selecting the food.
Absolutely. I call this my 3x3 system. It's a real 3x3 for safety and sustainability when it comes to grilling. Now that is a tongue twister. So one of the first area that I like to educate people on is sourcing your ingredients. You know, try to source locally because it helps with the economy, it helps with your community. You know, where are you getting from a farmer's market? I picked this morning, I was telling you during the break, from my friend's mother's backyard this morning. So we got rhubarb, peak of the season right now, strawberry, asparagus is just going out. I want to cook in the season because I know my food the transport time was less, so it's more nutrient dense. Sure. It's gonna be cheaper in the long run. It's gonna be healthier for me to eat.
Yeah.
Eat within the season. All of this is all from, you know, Minnesota grown. It's a great group that sources good products. If you can't find something that's local, then I say look for something sustainable. I have always looked for sustainable products, whether it be seafood or vegetables or oils. Mm-hmm. For example, I cooked some of these products with Malaysian certified sustainable palm oil.
Great.
You know, Malaysia does this great job. It takes 10 times less land to do this production than anything else. It's non-GMO, it's sustainable. So I grilled.
And I should mention with grilling, we wanted to be outside. Mother Nature's playing some tricks on us.
We got a little rain, and of course now it's sunny if you look behind us.
But is there a big mistake that people are making when it comes to grilling?
There is, because if you use certain oils, for example, I used to marinate, being Italian, I grew up, everything's marinated in olive oil. Mm-hmm. And then you cook with the olive oil, and I didn't know it, but sometimes it tastes really carcinogenic and burnt, like lighter fluid. Mm. It doesn't have the smoke point of some other oils. You know, you got peanut oil, which is a super high smoke point, but you have the allergy. So I go with one that's not. Well, we're going to thaw meat. Make sure you thaw it. This is a safety concern, in the refrigerator overnight. Too many people are rushed. They put it on the countertop. Next thing you know, you have E. coli or salmonella or any foodborne pathogens coming to life, and we need to be careful about that.
So you said in the fridge overnight?
In the fridge overnight. I grilled asparagus outside and the beef outside. I keep them separate. I know that asparagus takes a lot less time to cook than beef. I don't want to drag the beef over the asparagus, and then I don't cook off any of the bacteria, so that's done.
Mm-hmm.
It's dessert. How can you have life without dessert? I mean,
life
is too short.
It.
So this is what I call my deconstructed Midwestern dessert. Strawberry rhubarb pie is one of my all-time favorites.
Sounds amazing.
But I made a little lemon pound cake today, and this is a grilled rhubarb with some raspberries and some strawberries. As a chef, I've been fighting blood sugar issues my whole life, so I found this sustainable non-sugar sweetener, because I have to watch my sugar intake, and it's zero calories, it's non-GMO, it's sustainable. It's the same price I found. You can get this at Walmart and Walgreens for less than regular ones. So just to tie everything together, because I like a little bit of sweetness, but I got to watch what I eat.
Sure.
So you can cook all on the grill. And then one of the most ways to be sustainable, how much are you eating? This country has runaway portion sizes. Mm-hmm. And one thing I noticed going to restaurants around America, it's the 10-ounce steaks, the 12-ounce steaks, the 18-ounce T-bones. How much are you eating? We only really need, they say, the size of your fist for a portion size. 4 ounces of protein, 4 ounces of starch, 4 ounces of veg. 12 ounces is all you need. Some people eat more than that in a steak. So when you're grilling with your friends and neighbors, watch what you're throwing away so next time you can be a little bit more sustainable and prepare a little bit less.
Great to have you here.
Thank you
so much.
Me.
Hopefully the weather will cooperate next time. We can actually be outside. To review Chef Viverito's grilling tips, head to care11.com. Click on shows, then the news at 4. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Thank you so much.
Yeah.